Maijac Cottages and Marine, each cottage has a view of the lake. And they have a beautiful, safe, sandy beach, children's playground, and offer boat rentals for fishing on this extensive waterway. All of the cottages have fully equipped kitchens, including full-size fridge, stove, dishes, cooking utensils, coffee makers, microwaves, as well as three-piece bath, electric heat, upgraded bed and linens. They also provide outdoor chairs, picnic tables, umbrellas, and gas barbecues. Fishing maps of Lake Cecebe are available to their guests.
I'm looking for areas where I'm looking for like the most aggressive fish, the feeding fish. And I'll position my boat sometimes in that deeper edge. I like being close to deep water because the excess ability to get deep and shallow. So feeding fish all day long, they'll move back and forth, but we're gonna try this thing first thing this morning and see what fish are still around roaming, feeding. Because the reason why they come up on top of these points in the shallow stuff, and that's to eat. So little KVD, sexy dog, slow cadence. But again, I cast 12 o'clock, I call it. And then right to my right, all the way to 9 o'clock, 1 o'clock, 2 o'clock, all the way through an area. I'm fishing up in three, casting up to like five and stuff, sitting about 8 feet, cast up to five, then turn around, cast out to the deep stuff, looking for fish that are either coming in to feed, moving around, pack hunting, or still in the shallows. The sexy dog will find them. Come on. I know you have to be here. I know there has to be somebody here, dude. That's a good one. Yeah, he's moving some water too. Literally plays coy. Come right to the boat. There he goes. That's about the same like the other one. Look at him. Just, oh, gorgeous smallmouth, eh?
Wow. Wow.
That's what I live for right there. Seeing the blow up. Look at him go crazy. Oh, he's just got one hook in his mouth. Uh-oh. This could be bad. This could be bad. Could it be? Keep the tension on. Get your reliable net. Turtle, let's see. And once he's in there, you know the rest, don't you? It's history. You got a lot of spunk, huh? Lots of spunk. Look at that, beautiful. I want to take a picture of a couple of fish. He's a nice long fish too. He knew this is a classic area. Classic. Rocks and stuff. Deep water, 15 feet, up to 8 feet. Then there's all pads, more rock coming out. It's just a feeting zone. When you're fishing topwater, you look for that kind of stuff. Stuff where they can relate to. Deep water close by, come up to feed. And all day long, I can tell you, there'll be fish coming in and out of these areas. They just know where to feed. So throw your walking sexy dogs, your little cavity splashes, have some tube jigs or something as a backup plan, and I guarantee you'll catch them on top as well. Yep. Looks like a good largemouth too. What is too? Look at that, eh? Nice largey. Look at that. Nice largemouth sitting on the outside of them pads. Look at that. Think he wanted that? That's a decent little largemouth right there, boy. Decent. Right close to them pads. Bye. See ya. Largemouth with smallmouth. Edge of pads, points of rocks. Everything that swims wants to eat the little sexy dog. Incredible. You know, later on I'm gonna come around with plastics and stuff and try to fish these, but right now, this is roaming fish that you find in the morning. Take advantage of it. Tournaments, weekends, anytime you're bass fishing, hook up the topwater because you will catch those fish that are roaming and feeding.